Thank you for joining this quick getting started video. In this video, we're going to cover some of the basics when doing a forms-based login on the Salesforce app. The topics covered on this video also pertain to the other OAuth-enabled Salesforce-branded mobile apps such as Field Service Lightning Mobile, Salesforce Inbox, and Salesforce Authenticator. This video is applicable to both end users and admins. You'll notice the custom domain link on the standard login page. Although tempting to use when considering entering your My Domain or logging into a community, it is highly recommended to not be used. This can cause issues when logging into communities and for orgs set up with single sign-on authentication. If you don't have a My Domain configured for your org, you can go ahead and just enter in the appropriate username and password and click Login. However, some orgs may require users to navigate the app to the correct My Domain location first, prior to entering your login credentials, using the custom connection. To do this, click on the gear icon at the top right, and you'll notice this is where you can select either production, sandbox, or custom connection. Today we'll be demonstrating how to enter in a My Domain value, which your admin will need to share with the end users prior to logging in. Once entered, choose Apply, and you'll be taken back to the login page. Note, iOS version doesn't require https://to be entered in, but Android app version does require this. Ready to log in. Now we can simply enter in our username and password credentials. You'll be prompted after this with an allow or deny screen. This is part of our token management security, and all users should choose allow on the screen to proceed further. Next, note the prompt to create a PIN. This PIN is an option which the admin can choose to enable and allows users to log back in to the app without having to re-enter credentials. Once the PIN has been created, we're now in the Salesforce app. Now let's take a quick look at those connected app and additional login settings I just mentioned. This portion is for admins who may choose to take advantage of optional login behavior. Every mobile app accessing Salesforce needs to have its own connected app. The Salesforce app and other standard Salesforce mobile apps each have their own out-of-the-box connected app. Connected apps allow admins to configure who gets to log in and how long they will be allowed to stay logged into the app. This is also where the PIN can be enabled and configured. There are additional security options available here that this video will not cover. For admins requiring even more advanced login options, please see the help and training under Manage a Connected App. Lastly, we'll touch upon one additional configuration available to admins, which allows for advanced authentication scenarios. There are currently two settings available related to mobile under the Authentication Configuration session. Use the native browser for user authentication on iOS and use the native browser for user authentication on Android. These settings allow for the Salesforce app to defer the login to the local device browser for authentication and support methods such as delegated and certificate-based authentication. For more information on this, please see help and training under Customize Your My Domain Login page for mobile auth methods. Thank you for watching, and we hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions, please visit the Salesforce Help Portal, where you can find great resources including communities, documentation, trails, or you can also contact support. Happy trailblazing!